I'm Jeff Watson, and I've handled bears for 27 years. Over the last 3 months, I've taught my bears Bob and Screech the skills that they'll need to survive on their own. My plan is to release them in either Canada or Alaska. I rescued Bob and Screech, and I've been raising them since they were 6 weeks old. They're both a little over 4 years old right now, and that's the very tail end of when the mother would chase them off in the wild. I need to determine whether they're ready to go before this winter hits. I had to teach them how to fish.
Hey, let's go.
Bob.
Hey, you can't go home without catching a fish.
How to hunt.
You're supposed to chase it.
What is wrong with you? Are you a bear?
And how to forage.
Go look for some blackberries.
The fact of the matter is, Screech is progressing tremendously, but Bob is just lagging back.
Come on, Bob. Your foot bothering you?
Now I'm a little worried. If Bob is struggling with this lesson, I don't know how he's going to survive on his own. Daggone it. This is a problem. This is definitely going to be one of the hardest things I've ever had to do in my life.
And now, on the season finale of Project Grizzly.
Screech is really wound up. I've never seen him this excited before.
Crazy.
And you know, I could be in some serious danger now that they've acclimated themselves to life without depending on me.
Jeff, do you notice how when he stands up, he ends up losing his balance and he like flops back down? He's changed his gait since I saw him last. That's not good.
Well, what's the matter? You seem a little bummed out, I thought.
Well, just had a lot of stuff weighing on me.
Are you going to not follow your dream and then live the rest of your life wondering?
It's a tough decision, Jess. And now I have one final lesson to teach them, and that's how to fear man. Come on, Bob, daggone it. Give it to me.
Don't do this at home.
Come on, you freak. You don't know what that is? It's your brother.
It's okay, he's just rocking it.
It's a rabbit. Go chase it.
Woo-hoo!
Don't, guys, it's all the toilet paper I have.
Man, you guys need to run. You can't just reach out and try to grab it.
Yeah, high five.
Previously, the building of the new gorilla family was given a boost when Gabonese orphan Lococo was introduced to the three British youngsters. But young female Kuki took a vicious dislike to the newcomer just when head teacher Liz Pearson departed for a 6 week break.
6 weeks.
Left with the heavy burden of running gorilla school, Charlie's first day turned sour when he discovered that Damien's favorite graduate, Queeby, was desperately ill and now missing from his troop.
Queeby, who's been missing from his group since the 23rd of May.
With Damien returning to Gabon in just 2 days' time, can Charlie find Damien's old friend, Queeby?
Queeby, the lovely boy.
Boy.
And keep the new family together.
Handsome boy.
Abandoned by their mothers, three tiny gorillas are on an incredible journey. Taken from Howlett's Wild Animal Park in England to start a new life in Africa. One man has the vision to make this happen. Damien Aspinall's foundation has already begun to repopulate and protect 1 million acres of forest where gorillas once thrived. At his revolutionary gorilla school, two previous classes now live wild and free. But under constant threat from heavily armed hunters, these precious gorillas must be protected by a brave team of eco-guards and monitored round the clock by specialist trackers. But this new class are Damien's greatest challenge yet, the youngest and most vulnerable infants ever taught at gorilla school. Their lives will be in the hands of Damien Aspinall's carefully selected team of gorilla experts. And they'll be taught by local surrogate fathers and wild orphan gorillas. An experiment never attempted before. We'll follow every struggle these infants face as they battle to become the most groundbreaking graduates from gorilla school.
This is Bear Country. Lake Tahoe on the California-Nevada border is Bear Town. But bears are in danger, and only one woman can save them. Anne Bryant understands Tahoe's bears like no other.
Love you, baby.
But Anne also knows that every year, 10% are killed as a turf war breaks out between people and bears.
Oh my God. Claw marks.
Each year, thousands of visitors flock to the shores of Lake Tahoe.
Most of them don't know how to deal with seeing a bear walking across the street, much less in their yard.
Bears are lured into town by what people leave behind. With powerful bears on the loose and people armed with traps and guns, Anne unleashes her unique brand of tough love to protect her bears. Pushes her toward the edge.
Why don't you listen to me?
You're a fanatic.
It's the death trap. It's hard to contain my anger when people are deliberately wanting to kill the creatures I adore.
I can't take it.
Anne has launched this year's impassioned battle to get through the 10-week tourist season without a single injury or death.
I'm responsible for these bears, and I will not let them down.
The captain's decision reinvigorates Anne.
This is the way it should be.
And a special moment shared with Sad Face reminds her why she continues to fight for the animal she believes she's destined to protect.
This is my reward. This is my paycheck. Love you, baby. Handsome, beautiful boy. You take good care of yourself, okay? Don't you get into any trouble. I don't want anything to ever happen to you. You stay safe.